Hello, welcome to the News Digest this week. I am Vivian Kamsimi. Term limits were removed from the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, but recently the National Unity Platform Delegates Conference put term limits on elected leaders within their party and other leaders in the party. That means that the presidents of the party, the secretary general, and the members of parliament, the councillors, shall not exceed the two-term limits that they set. We speak to the Secretary General David Louis Rubongoya of the National Unity Platform. Thank you for joining us. From the moral sense of politicians, can they adhere to these two-term limits?
Yeah, first of all, this was not something imposed on them. Members of Parliament are part of the Delegates Conference, and it is a matter we debated with them. At the end of the day, majority of the delegates, maybe over 70%, felt that it was a right thing to do, it was a moral thing to do, to have term limits. And term limits do not only affect those elected leaders at those levels, they affect me as well. As Secretary General, I'm not allowed to be in office for more than two terms. They affect our president. Even as a president of the party, he cannot be in office for more than two terms. So essentially, we're having these term limits to try and bring sanity in our party, but most importantly, to communicate to the nation that if we come to power, or when we come to power, we are going to have term limits reinstated in the Constitution and other laws of Uganda, because we believe that leaders should really be changed regularly, because if you stay for long in power or in a particular position, you start owning it, and we believe in institutionalization, so we want to build stronger institutions and not stronger individuals.
How are you going to enforce these two-term limits on elected leaders?
The Constitution is a Constitution. As long as that is what it says, then no one will even dare come to say, I want to be a leader after my term has expired.
Are you prepared for leaders who will leave NUP and come as independents?
Of course, it wouldn't be what we want. And we believe that our leaders will stick. I mean, all of us leaders will stick to what we have said, because this is something we have agreed on. We don't want people to be like, every time the term limits expire, he extends them and that kind of thing. We hope our people will be able to stick to their term limits.
Do you have punishments for those who will defy the two-term limits?
Of course, if you go independent, then you're no longer a member of NUP. That's a penalty. Our constitution says that if you stand as an independent or stand under another political party, then you're no longer a member of the party. So those who choose to go and run independent will no longer be members of NUP.
How is NUP coming to terms with bringing together politicians with two tendencies, the radical politicians and the moderates?
As you can see, NUP, that's why we are the National Unity Platform. We bring people from different understandings of things and that kind of thing. And so far, we are able to move together with all manner of leaders as long as we are shooting the same objective. So those who are radical, those who are moderate, all of them have a home in NUP. But as long as all of us are pushing towards the same direction.
Finally, David, let me ask you again. How will you instill the morality and the discipline of adherence to the Constitution in your members when we don't see that on social media?
Well, the people who attack others the most are NRM people, who don't just attack you on social media, but abduct you, torture you, and do all sorts of things to you. So before you ask us about people who insult each other on social media, I think the people who commit bigger crimes are those who abduct people and torture them and for disagreeing with them. That said, even in NUP, one of the things we have in our constitution, you'll see, is a code of conduct. And after our constitution has been gazetted, we shall start implementing that code of conduct. First of all, to train and encourage our people to move on a certain code of conduct and to really abide by these rules that we've put in place. But like I said, the biggest problem is not people who are insulting each other on social media. It is the people who torture, who abduct people, who keep people in detention without trial and such other things.
Well, that has been David Louis Rubongoya, the Secretary General of National Unity Platform. Until next week, the News Digest.